Welcome back to the vlog. Welcome back here to Papua New Guinea. My name is Ryan. We're out here at Ibai today. 11% slope, like 454 meters or something close to that. Anyways, we're going to be taking off with like an 8 to 10 knot crosswind, sometimes quartering to tailwind, and we're on the side of a mountain. And on the way back, I'm going to show you guys a cool waterfall. I saw it coming in. It's been raining out here quite a bit lately, so just tons of water is coming over it. So let's get started. Go check out that waterfall. Head back to Goroka on just like a 15-minute flight. Introduce my fuel watch, my NG here. Come up over 30%, then I watch the ITT as it's popping up to probably 650 or so.
TAWS system test, okay.
Your generator on, push our prop forward while our generator spikes for a second. Now it's coming down. We'll throw our alternator on, as well as our aux bus, our V2 tracker. All up Moresby. Moresby 6598, November Tango Echo taxi.
November Tango Echo Morphe, go ahead.
November Tango Echo taxi, Ibai Goroka, 1 POB.
November Tango Echo.
We're 5,100 pounds, so we'll rotate at 53.
November Tango Echo, confirm destination amended Goroka.
Affirmative amended Goroka, November Tango Echo.
November Tango Echo.
I forgot, I'm going back to Goroka. I was supposed to go somewhere else, but that flight was canceled. So now I'm just going back to Goroka. All stations Ibai 1201, November Tango Echo taxiing Ibai Goroka. Being rough at the top of this airstrip, that is for sure. I'm coming out of here empty today, so I don't really care that I have a crosswind or even a tailwind at that. Just go beta so it's not pulling me down the hill as I turn around. There we go, get my brake on for a second. Fuel caps are good. Control, our fuel's on, selector's on, controls I just did a second ago. We'll turn TAWS, our terrain awareness system, off. Switches and instruments, we'll go back at 7,000. We've got our 61 knots and 53 knots in here. It says low fuel just because we're bouncing around. And by attitude indicator, cage doesn't really know what to do on the bouncy hill. Our igniter's on, all of our lights are on, bypass. All that's good. We've got 20 degrees of flaps set, indicated and verified. Someone was asking, how do you know they're verified? There's like a flap track that goes down, and when I look out, it actually lines up with the bottom of the flap, and that's how I know that I'm verifying that it is a 20, or if it was lower than that, the flap hangs lower than that. Coming aboard, it's kind of slippery today. We're really going to be brakes release on this one, as when we're committed. We'll peel off to the right if we do lose power. Down towards lower terrain, consider EPL, consider feather, otherwise cut off, pull off, and shut off. 85 then 84 flaps, emergency's master crack my door. Everybody always asks, why do you crack your door? In case the fuselage bends and plane catches on fire, I can still get out of the door so I don't get trapped in here. 24 degrees, 6,300. 24, oh, let's say 1270. Ignition condition, flaps 20, fuel and harnesses, 1270. Rotate 63, or whenever it lets us get off the ground. And it's probably gonna be slippery, so I'm probably just gonna go once I start sliding. At 1270. And we're going. All right, torque set, ITT's good. Bounce down. There's airborne, there's the crosswind. Oh, that's a big correction already.
Don't sink.
All right, 10 knots on the nose now. I'm so happy that I was able to get what I did, because I had 8 knots landing on the nose, and now I've got, I had 10 knots taking off, so I wouldn't have been able to land otherwise. Let's get our flaps up, head over this way, show you guys that really pretty waterfall. Air prop to 2000. Orsby 6598, November Tango Echo, departure.
November Tango Echo, Morse, go ahead.
November Tango Echo, departed I-by on the hour. We'll be tracking up to 5 miles right of track, 089er on climb, not above 7,000, estimating Goroka 15.
Number that, Tango Echo, roger, traffic is Alpha Hotel Papa, Cessna Caravan, texting Goroka for Gawa, 8,000 on departure.
Copy Alpha Hotel Papa, and say again destination.
Destination, Guasa.
Copy Guasa, November Tango Echo. Alright, it should be coming up like right in here somewhere. I saw it when I was coming in that way, so it should be right over here, but I don't really know where. Alright, there's a big cutout over here. I wonder if that's it. There it is. Wow, that's cool. Thank you, Insta360 camera, so I can show you guys this. That is so cool. A lot of times during the dry season, these things just sort of sprinkle colors. It's like a tiny little stream coming out. But today, we've got another one right over here on this side. That one doesn't have quite as much water, but still pretty nonetheless. All right, well, I'm going to go ahead and climb up now. I'm going to go ahead and push my ITT up to 720 for the climb up out of here. And because I've got a plane coming in right over there, I'm just going to go ahead and start getting my flaps, go 20 degrees of flaps. And start pitching for 73 knots, and that's going to give me my best angle of climb, X, so I get as most amount of altitude and the shortest amount of distance. That way I can get over top of Mount Ulambari, stay out of the way of one of the MAF caravans. There's 73 knots, a little bit more coordinated. And now I'm going to go ahead and lower my nose, my speed back up, and then hopefully go for more of a VY climb to get over these next hills in front of me. Because they're a little bit further out, I don't need to continue climbing at 73. I have lots and lots and lots of right rudder pressure right now though. I'm going to pitch for 99 knots. That should get me over these next hills here, just barely, but just enough. All stations Goroka. And Alpha Hotel Papa, November Tango Echo is just on the southwest side of Ulambari. Will be 7,000 tracking for the call. As the chimes let me know, it's 200 feet more to go to 7,000. There's 7,000, we'll just stay right here at this altitude. I've shown you guys along this cliff face right here at Ulambari. Really cool cave. If you guys want to check out, go find some other videos. Going out of I-by, and I go on that. Now we're up to 7,000. Let me bring my torque on back as I get thrown around. Let's do Goroka on the second comm. That way I can keep listening for Alpha Hotel Papa coming out of here on the other frequency.
November Tango Echo, on all stations southwest of Goroka, 1201 Alpha Hotel Papa, Cessna Caravan. We're outbound Goroka, we're south of the Kuku, now passing 7,300, on climb 8,000, tracking southwest bound for Guasa.
And Alpha Hotel Papa, November Tango Echo, just on the west southwest side
November Tango
of Ulambari.
Alpha Hotel
500.
We've got you on ADSB, and I'll have a look at
Goroka Tower, November Tango Echo.
November Tango Echo, Goroka Tower.
November Tango Echo, 15 miles to the west, 7,200 tracks to the call. Copy Alpha Hotel Papa, your circuit 13.
November Tango Echo Tower, your transmission slightly broken there. Runway 35 right, wind light and variable, the QNH 1017, and track and report left base.
1017, track report, left base 35 right, and copy outbound traffic, Alpha Hotel Papa, November Tango Echo. Your circuit 13.
November Tango Echo, roger.
Alpha Hotel Papa is just heading out to Guas. I've taken you guys out there one time, I think. I've tried a few times, the weather getting in and out of there, especially after 11 in the morning. just makes it difficult. It's 11:10 right now, so the winds here in these mountains right here just kind of swirl around, don't really know what to do, which just makes landing 10 times more difficult. There's no wind. It would be so much easier. But add a little bit of wind in there with tailwinds and downdrafts and stuff, it just makes your life a lot harder because you just can't see the wind until you're right there. Selectors and brakes, our TAWS is off, our VREF, we are 5100, so we'll be landing at 61 knots. I've already got that set up in there. Lights and inlets, done and done. If we have to go around, it's power up, 20 degrees of flaps, pitch for 73 knots, maneuver is required. We'll do pop and harness here in a second. We can do harness now though. Come through the call around 7,300, that's a nice altitude to come through and gives plenty of clearance in case we have any downdrafts or anything like that. Just put in a lot of left rudder trim right now in my descent. Because I pulled the power, I'm also going down. I don't need that right rudder in there anymore, so put a bunch of that in there just to keep myself coordinated on the way down. I mentioned this in some other videos, but if you're a pilot and you're struggling with like not getting your circuit, or even if you're in a flight simmer and you're not getting your circuits down right, if you fly to the same places, pick out key positions that you can fly to that you know what altitudes you need to be at, so that if you're not at that altitude or that speed, you can make adjustments before you get there. So on your final, you're not in a rush to get things done. Broken Tower, November Tango Echo, turning left base 35 right.
November Tango Echo, runway 35 right, clear to land.
Got to land 35 right, November Tango Echo. And if you're a flight simmer and you want to learn how to fly this Kodiak, maybe for X-Plane or even Microsoft Flight Sim, check out the link below. I have an e-course that you guys can take where I do a lot of G1000 stuff as well as very specific Kodiak operations. So if you're really interested in learning how to fly the Kodiak well, check that link out down below. All right, checklist is complete. I'm still about 200 feet high. We'll get there though. So I know I want to be 1.8 indicated at 5600 turning final. There is turning final now at 5600.
500.
And that should give me a nice 550 feet per minute descent, which is what we're looking for in the Kodiak. Two knots of headwind, four knots of crosswind. I'm just gonna come in at 70 knots because I'm empty. I don't really care to land exactly at the end of the runway. All right, expecting a downdraft right here over this road. Not today. Continuing. I float forever down the runway today, it looks like. If you guys thought those waterfalls were pretty cool, give this video a thumbs up. It helps my channel get to many other people. So thanks for watching, I sure do appreciate it. If you want to pick up some sunglasses that look like this, check out my website down below. Got different merch and sunglasses as well as these checklist boxes, which are a huge help for myself, especially for someone who's kind of borderline ADD. So helps you stay focused and it helps you make sure that you cover all of your critical takeoff and landing items. And welcome here to Goroka. down, I get my fuel. We're 380. Get my hobs down here, 72.1. Turn off my air, turn off my lights, turn off my aux generator, alternator. I'm watching my NG. Once it gets below 15%, I turn off my aux fuel pump, and that's it. See you guys next time.